Hi guys, it's Kiarko here, back with another character speed build. So this is going to be a multi-part series called Opposites Attract. It's not very much a long series. It'll be like one, two, maybe three videos. But basically this came off of an idea that Robin submitted, which is to create two apartments, a gothic book reader's apartment, and that's who we're creating right now, our gothic loving book reader, and a pastel apartment. And I kind of combined this with an idea from Midori, who submitted an idea on the Discord, which was to build like a Sanrio core slash baby core aesthetic build. And that kind of fit perfectly with the whole like pastel apartment idea vibe. So I just kind of like mixed those two ideas together. Yeah, that's what this video is. Basically, we are going to create two neighbors. One of the neighbors, obviously, is a, you know, gothic aesthetic, book-loving person. And then their neighbor is going to be this pastel Sanrio core kind of apartment neighbor. So we're creating the neighbors in this video. So this is just a pure character creation video. And in the next video, we'll be doing their apartment. So I'm really excited for this mini-series just because, like, I love doing like opposite things, you know, like super gothic and then super like cutesy pastel-y. I think it'll be really, really interesting. And it's called Opposites Attract because I thought, you know, maybe they'll fall in love or something like that, or become besties, or, you know, whatever. We're just gonna have fun with it. I'm creating the two characters right now. We're starting off again with the book reader. So her name is Marigold Winters. And I figured that she's either, you know, I couldn't exactly decide. She's either some sort of librarian, or maybe she's like, I thought about her being like a PhD student, like she's studying to get her PhD or something like that. Something academic, I feel like, is definitely her vibe because she loves to read. You know, Robin's idea was that she was a book reader and a book lover, so I really like the idea of her having, you know, some sort of academic or book-related profession. So she's either like a grad student or like a PhD student or, you know, a librarian. But she is so cute. I love her little earrings especially, and I love these like black round glasses on her. We're gonna go through and do her whole outfits. Usually I sometimes just do their everydays, but in this case we're gonna do everyday, formal, athletic, all of them. You know, just to round out the characters and get a good look at them. By the way, I am feeling a little bit sick again. It sucks. Like, I was sick and then I felt better and now I'm getting sick again, and I'm not in the mood to be sick, but I am. So if I sound stuffy or my throat sore, that is why. I apologize. I know it's not fun to listen to me sounding like this, but as you can see, I'm putting together her everyday outfit. So obviously she loves gothic stuff, and I'm talking more about, because you know how like goth in general is kind of like a very large genre. Like, there's a lot of different subgenres of goth, you know, like there's, my mind is totally blanking right now. There's like a cyberpunk goth, and there's like, you know, there's different goths. You know what I'm talking about. Like, there's like different kinds of aesthetics. For her, I specifically was thinking about like, I'm definitely not gonna get the correct name for this, but I was thinking about kind of like traditional, old school kind of Victorian gothy, you know what I mean? Let me know if you're getting that vibe. Kind of like academic goth, I guess. And you can kind of see that in her everyday outfit, which we've already moved past from. But she had like this cute little like neck bow, and she's wearing really dark colors. And, you know, she's definitely like kind of like an elegant, you know, academic goth, I would describe it as. But I'm really excited to do her apartment. I love doing like gothic interiors, you know, like playing around with all the dark, rich colors. And we're going to bring in a bunch of like books and bookshelves and, you know, places for her to read, like all these little reading corners. I'm excited to build her apartment. I hope you guys are going to enjoy it too. So in terms of her character, obviously she's a book lover. I also imagine she's like a genius, like she's very, very intelligent because of all the books she reads. She just like has a lot of information in her head that she knows. And she is gonna be kind of a perfectionist, because I wanted to give both of them like one trait that wasn't like exactly perfect about them, just so they were a little bit more rounded out as characters. So I feel for her trait's gonna be that she's a perfectionist, that she really needs things to be in a certain way, or she really needs, you know, to finish like a book before she starts another book. You know what I mean? Like, she has her way of doing things, and she's very like straightforward about that kind of thing. And then we'll look at her neighbor in just a second here, but like I said, her name is Marigold Winters, and her neighbor's last name is gonna have Summers as her last name, so I thought that'd be a cute, you know, opposites thing. You know that whole saying, you know, opposites attract? I don't think it's true in real life. I mean, I think in terms of, you know, aesthetics and style and, you know, what kind of music you like. Like, things like that, I feel like opposites can totally attract. But in terms of, like, personality conflict, I don't know if you could date someone, like, with the exact opposite of your personality. I don't know. Like, I'm not a psychologist, and I'm certainly not a marriage counselor, but I feel like, I don't know, that's just not been my experience. Let me know if I'm wrong about that, though, if anyone is like, oh, yeah, I'm this way, my partner is totally this way, you know? Maybe opposites do attract, and I'm just wrong, but... Yeah, this is her neighbor. Her name is, I'm trying to remember, Cassandra, because I thought it'd be, because it's Marigold and Cassandra, so I thought it'd be cute if Marigold's nickname was Goldie and her nickname was Cass, so it's Goldie and Cass. I just thought that was cute. I don't know. They sound like a really cute old couple, you know what I mean? Like, Goldie is such like a, it just reminds me of a grandma for some reason, but I thought that'd be cute, you know? So, anyways, this is Cassandra. She is absolutely stunning. I love her face. I think she's so beautiful. And so is Marigold, too. I just really like her eye color here. Like, this, like, grayish blue is just so interesting. And I love this hairstyle on her. I made her kind of blonde, which probably isn't her natural hair color. I figure she probably does not have naturally blonde hair, but I just like the idea of her dyeing her hair, and I love the shade of blonde that this was on this particular hair. It's absolutely stunning. This is a beautiful hairstyle. Like, look at the detail. Man, custom content creators blow me away all the time. But Cassandra is, you know, gonna have the pastel apartment, you know, the Sanrio core apartment. So she more loves, you know, like pink things and ruffles and very cutesy kind of stuff. And obviously I'm gonna reflect that in her outfits. She's gonna be wearing pink like all the time. But she's very cutesy and pretty. So in terms of her personality and her character, so one, I figured that she is very outgoing. I like the idea of her being very, you know, open and talkative and kind of like bringing out this, this not extroverted side, but she brings out more, not charisma, what's the word? I can't think of the word. She brings out more socializingness in Marigold. So she kind of complements Marigold's, not necessarily a reclusive personality, but I figured because she's reading and in her apartment all the time, she probably isn't very social, and I feel like Cass could like bring out that in her. Cass is also gonna be kind of clumsy. She has the clumsy trait. Like I said, I wanted to give them both like a minorly negative trait just to, you know, round them out. So I thought that her clumsiness would kind of contrast with Cassandra's perfectionism, with Marigold's perfectionism, because, you know, maybe sometimes Cass makes a mistake or knocks something over or, like, you know, falls and I don't know. All I can think of is her knocking things over, dropping things because she's so clumsy. And I figured that would be like a point of conflict between the two that they would have to like work out with each other, you know? But yeah, opposites attract. I like that title for a miniseries. But they both use she, her pronouns, and they are both lovely, lovely people. I'm doing her swimsuit now, and then we're doing her hot weather outfit. As you can see, lots of pink, lots of white, ruffles, cute things. What did I do for a winter wear? Honestly, I don't like her winter wear outfit. I feel like I should have gone in a different direction with it, but the rest of her outfits I really, really do like. But like I said, this is just the character build. I will be releasing their two apartments after this video. So stay tuned for those. I'm not sure if we'll do them both in the same video or not. We'll have to see. But let me know what you think. Are you guys excited to see where they live? What do you think of them as opposites? And how do you think they're gonna mesh? And, you know, how would they get to know each other and bond? Like, how would they get from being so opposite and so head-to-head and get to the place where they're either, you know, best friends or in a romantic relationship or something like that? What do you think their trajectory is? Let me know. Anyways, that's the video. As always, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.